Welcome to this session of my video series. Destructors are functions, very similar to constructors. When an object is created, the constructor is automatically called by the compiler. A destructor is also automatically called, but when the object is dying away. Let's see a simple program. This is the point when the object is created. The constructor is called at this point. At this point, the function ends. The class object dies at this point. So the destructor is called at this point. Take another example. This is a code block. The constructor for the second object is called at this point. The destructor for the object is called at this point because the scope is ending here. Let's take yet another example. This is a global object of a class. It is not created inside any function. The constructor for this object is called before entering main. The destructor for a global object is called after the main exits. Destructor is a special function. It is written in a special way. This class has a constructor and the destructor. Both of them are special functions. The destructor has the same name as the class. A tilde is used to distinguish it from the default constructor. This tilde distinguishes a destructor from the default constructor. There is no return from a destructor. No return type is mentioned when a destructor is defined. The name of the destructor is exactly the same as the name of the class. A class cannot have more than one destructor. This is a class that has two constructors and the destructor. These are two constructors of this class. One is the default constructor, and the other, a parameterized. A class can contain multiple overloaded constructors. It is because an object can be constructed in a number of ways. This is the constructor of this class. A class can have only one destructor. Overloaded destructors are not possible for a class. A A class can have multiple overloaded constructors. Overloaded destructors are not possible in a class. I shall explain this code in detail. This is a class with a constructor and its destructor. This is a constructor of this class. This is the destructor. A message is printed inside this destructor. It will help us know that the destructor has been called. The class object is created inside the class here. We expect the constructor to be called here. This is any message printed inside main. The main ends at this point and we expect the destructor to be called. This is the output when we run this code. Constructor is called at this point. Then this message is printed. Finally, this message is printed when the main ends. This class will help you know why destructors are required. This class holds a data member of a pointer type. It might be very confusing to a new person. You will feel better if you think a pointer to be just a data type. A class can hold data members of any type, int or int pointer. So an int star is equally possible, that's what has been done here. The address of the new allocation has been stored in the class data member. This allocates memory on the heap. One int is allocated on the heap, and automatically filled with a value. The address of the new number is stored inside the class data member. Here a message has been printed. Inside the destructor, the memory is released back to the heap. This should explain why we need a destructor. A destructor is used for performing an automated cleanup. As soon as the object is about to die, the destructor releases any heap allocations. Since the destructor is called automatically, there is no possibility of memory leaks. We are not required to create cleanup functions. A developer could forget to call them, leading to memory leaks. The compiler is providing us with a hook where we can write our code. Destructor is helps us through any automated cleanup. It is a good programming practice to set a pointer to zero after deleting a memory. A second delete on a zero pointer is ignored, but leads to a program crash otherwise. Destructor can be called through an object. They can be called like normal functions. Constructors can be called only by the compiler, not through an object. This is the data member. Here the pointer is being initialized through an allocation on the heap. Memory is being freed in the destructor. The pointer is set to zero. This will ensure that a second deletion doesn't cause error. Here we create an object of the class. And this is the explicit call. The destructor is being called through a class object. This is similar to calling a member function of the class. Such a call of the destructor is called an explicit call. This is the output of this code. There are two destructor calls as we can see. The first call is this explicit call. This call has taken place through the object, explicitly. The second call takes place when the object is deleted here. This call is made by the compiler. The second call is safe because of this. It will crash if you attempt to delete an already released object. The second call would have crashed the application. But setting this pointer to zero prevented that from happening. Why would anyone make an explicit call? The answer lies in placement new. An explicit call is required if allocation of a data member is through placement new. That's a bit of an advanced concept, so I am leaving it here. Thank you.